steps.
We're running these.
We're gonna run it, and we're gonna see how we can do it together.
Let's go. Keep on going! Let's do it. Oh, and that was it. Woo. Yo, Adrian. Woo. Oh my gosh. That cardio. It's crazy, but we just ran the Rocky Steps. We did it in Philadelphia. You have to do it at least once in your life. Even if it's corny as hell, you have to do it. So we did it. We're here. Check out Philly in the background. That was fun. All right, we're still in Philadelphia. We made it to Hermit's Cave, but the problem is we're trying to figure out where it is because it put us in the middle of a park, and I think it's in the woods somewhere around here.
I got 0.7 miles.
0.7 miles? All right, we're gonna go try to find this place, and we're probably gonna be walking through the woods.
Actually, Trey, 0.7 miles if it does this big loop, so I think it's gonna be like a quarter of a mile.
Okay, so maybe a quarter of a mile from where we are, we're gonna try to find it.
Trail.
There doesn't seem to be a trail. There's no signs. This was where a Doomsday cult met. Kelpius Cave.
Johannes Kelpius.
Johannes Kelpius, a German. Apparently he and his group had one of the first observatories in the United States as well. And this cave represented a social gathering place for the group. And their houses originally were along the river, the Schuylkill River. I think it's a Schuylkill. You may want to double check me on that. But they would all congregate in this cave, and there was this belief in the imminent return of Christ or the end of the world. And so, oddly enough, we're here around 6 p.m. There is no one else around, and there are no signs. So, but we're going to find this place. We're gonna find this cave. You see an entrance over here?
Any? No, but are you ready to go native?
Really? Is it that bad? Alright, so.
As long as there's no poison ivy, I don't care.
Is it right down here? I mean, it's
look,
literally.
Look. Look.
There's got to be a better way. Maybe we're just...
I mean, how do we even know that that's it?
Well, there's something moving over there.
Where?
Squirrels or something? Hey, look, I've been in the Costa Rican rainforest, so this shouldn't be too much of a stretch.
See what happens.
All right, let's go. All right, we're cutting across a baseball field at Daisy Park. Because we started going the wrong way. We hit a bunch of vegetation and overgrowth and couldn't find our way. So we're backtracking and we think we have a path. This is it. All right. So I'm gonna go see Kelpius's cave. He came here with his followers from Germany around 1694, thinking the world was gonna end in the year 1700, which is a common misplaced doomsday perception. There are always cults that think the world is going to end. In the Jewish tradition, Shabtai Tzvi was thought to be the Messiah. You have, of course, Jesus. And there's been plenty of other people, all the way up to David Koresh and Jim Jones, but... Yeah. The Heaven's Gate cult. But these guys weren't suiciders. These were These are smart men.
They just had a really obscure translation of Revelation.
Yeah, literalist, I guess, or obscure would probably be a better word, yes, because they tried to use mathematics to calculate actual dates and did a lot of, precarious calculations to get to the number that they wanted.
Dude, this is freaky. I mean, clearly people have been here. There's a lot of foot traffic and, you know, footprints and bike tread, but maybe even a little litter, but still has a really odd feel to it.
Well, it's about 50 feet up here on the left. So I think we've found the cave. We're going to take a look. And there it is. There's a marker. Wow, you better put your flashlight on when we go in. Come on. It's a squirrel. It's on the tree. It gets a little freaky out here. It's like the Blair Witch Project.
Yeah, every little thing you hear.
Wow. How nuts is this?
Dude.
Oh my gosh.
You have a PhD?
Alright, so let's figure. Johannes Kelpius, PhD. It's cold coming in from there. The God-loving soul, Magister of the first Rosicrucian AMORC colony. So Rosicrucianism, if you don't understand, is considered one of the, I guess, secret cults that were very popular about 300-400 years ago, similar to Freemasonry. It migrated into the colonies of America. So it says that this colony arrived in Philadelphia on June 24th, 1694, then known as the Monks of the Ridge. Fra Kelpius used this cave as a shelter and as a sanctum for his meditations, lovingly erected to his memory by the Grand Lodge of Rosicrucians. So, 1961, in cooperation with the Supreme Grand Lodge. Very, very cryptic, guys. Let's take a look inside. Well, unless a bear comes out. You want to give me some light? Or I'll just do it.
Yeah, we should both use our flashlight.
Alright, come on. Well, there's bags in here.
Yeah, I'm sure there's a lot of evidence of people.
Yep. Yeah, you can't really see in here, guys. You want to put your flashlight on, Chris, as well?
This is it, huh? It's just one. I thought it was all.
Keep your flashlight
out. I thought it was going to be a whole thing.
Yeah, me too. So this is just basically a hole in the wall. It's cool.
Look.
See, we got some crazy cave crickets in here. There's one over your head right there.
Mm-hmm.
That is a big boy. Oh, they're all over the place.
Okay. And that's enough.
Hold on. Hold on. Come here. Can I use your flashlight then?
Mm-hmm.
Hold on.
Here.
Yeah, so come over here. Let's get.
I mean, how are you going to sit here with your followers
and meditate? Well, bugs don't bother you.
No, I mean, if you got a whole bunch of followers, what are you supposed to do?
Think about how long ago this cave dates back to, where there were people in here. But it would probably be like any cave if you think about it, guys. The ancestors. Native Americans in this land probably use caves all the time. And we're discovering it as if it were something new, but these may have been long abandoned. But they were certainly habitable at one point. Here's a cave cricket too.
I guess you eat the bugs.
Probably. Hey buddy, you are huge. And you're gone.
Somebody tried to start a fire in here, burning a phone book, maybe trying to make a night out of it.
Interesting.
Huh. Not as cool in here as I thought.
A little underwhelming, yeah. So let's see here. We've got something that looks like a hinge. So maybe at some point there was a door hinge here, maybe? I don't know. And we don't see evidence of anything else, but the wood on the side here almost looks petrified when you touch it. It's a very weird feeling, almost like stone. And the stones are bricks, it looks like, laid on top of one another and built into the side here. So the cave itself, although there may have been some kind of cave here, everything on the inside, as you've already seen, is stone. And so I'm wondering if this is more of a man-made project than, say, something that was naturally occurring in the wilderness.
They probably dug out the earthworks, lined it with stone, and then came in here to meditate and get away from everything.
Yeah. But it looks like, if you look down here, see, there was a hinge on the top. There's an open hole here. I wonder if this was stolen at some point or removed, because that would be the only other place I would see for it. And then it looks like there's a latch, maybe, or some kind of mechanism that was there. Yeah.
Yeah.
That locked. So maybe they came down here and closed the doors off completely. We ended our day checking out a Doomsday cult. A little underwhelming, simply because it's just one room inside of there, not a series of caves with different sub-rooms. But either way, thanks again, Philadelphia. We enjoyed it. This is my brother, Chris. And remember to travel with Trey on YouTube. We'll see you next time.
Good one.